Enjoy having you at our little song fest, folks. So gather around. Here we go. I'm going to get Sally to start us out.
Oh,
Sally?
Oh,
you got a little tune for us, honey?
Yes, I have, Pat.
What's the name of it?
Buckaroo, Sandman.
Well, we don't want to go to sleep, but I'll bet this will keep us awake, huh?
I hope so, Pat.
All right, boys, let's go.
It's the Buckaroo Sandman.
Thing in the world. It sounded all right to me. Say, can we get Cupie up here? Come here, Cupie. Sally's got a little song here, and I think I heard you two singing this song together. It's called My Birmingham Rose or something like that.
Okay, Pap, we'll sure try.
All right, gather in there real close now. Called off Cupie, but
I don't mind that. I don't mind.
Well, as long as we get you out of that kitchen long enough to sing a song, I'm satisfied. Well, I got a little story for you now, kid. I think you're going to like this. It's a little story I call Dapper and the Mousetrap. It's all right. Dapper Collins, you know, as I remember him now, was a little sort of a guy, but a mighty fine cook he was. Yes, sir, that gentleman could whip up a batch of victuals in less time than it takes me to talk about it. And of a morning, his coffee aroma would drift in and drive you crazy till you get up for a cup of it. But like his name suggests, Dapper was one of these fellows who can't rest when anything is out of place or untidy. It was just his nature. So you can imagine how he got along on the ranch. Yeah, the rest of us would come steaming in dirty as a bunch of tramps, throw some water on our face and hands, and then clamor for the grub. Well, Dapper realized there wasn't much he could do about that, but it sure did gripe his soul. Yes, every once in a while, he'd tack up signs on the wall that read, "Cleanliness is a virtue," or "Think of your neighbor, be clean," something like that. Yeah, Dapper meant well, he did, but he just couldn't get very far with the rest of us. His kitchen, though, was perfect. Everything shined like a silver dollar. You could see your face in any one of the pots and pans hanging on the wall. So you can imagine what happened one night when he saw a mouse go scooting across the floor. Mm-hmm. Yes, sir, it liked to kill him. Oh, he didn't scream or anything like that. He wasn't afraid of it. He was just plumb horrified. And the thought of that mouse having the nerve to run across the part of the floor that he walked on was just too much for him to swallow. So that started him on a mouse hunt. Yeah, he got himself some traps and put them out in the kitchen. No results. Not one mouse. Naturally, though, because it was so spick and span, I guess. So then he says to all of us that he's going to put traps in the bunkhouse. Well, we quickly put an end to that idea because we all got visions of hopping out of bed into a mouse trap, and it didn't go so good. Yeah, we said that he could have a mouse trap by his bed, but only one if he wanted to. Well, that seemed to make him kind of happy, so he baited the trap and put it right by his bunk. About an hour after he was in bed, there was a click. Dapper jumped out of bed and put his hand under to get the mouse. All he got was a trap on the end of his fingers. Well, night after night, it would happen the same way. There'd be a sort of a click, and then Dapper'd pile out of bed and get caught in that trap again. But we could all hear that click just plain as day. And then finally, I realized, that is, I found out what it was. Old man McCarthy, one of the cowhands there, slept in the bunk right next to Dapper. And he had new false teeth. Yeah, and just before he'd fall off to sleep, he'd kind of shift his face a little bit, and them doggone teeth would click like. Sounds just like a mousetrap. So after that, Dapper just give up. Yeah, he said he knew we was all against him. But when a man's false teeth, too, he figured that. And that's what he did. Well, now, I'm ready to hear a little song. I Let me see. You were singing one the other day, Skeets, I like, called Goodbye Cowboy.
Yeah, Pappy.
You got that in handy?
Yeah, I got that in handy.
Let's hear it, will you?
All right. We used to ride up the East Coast when traveling to and fro. But now we ride airplanes and border things can go. Get on in California, eat dinner down in Maine. And when it's time for supper, you're almost home again. We always rode our ponies when into town we'd go. But now we take the auto and start her out and low. We shift her in the second and then we go to high. Just keep her on the highway and watch the miles go by.
Tells us our time's about up, doesn't it? Doggone it, time, doesn't it? Doggone it, time just slips away from us before we know it. But we want you to know that you're always welcome in the old corral. So suppose we make a date right now for the next time we get together for our little song fest. We'll enjoy having you. This is Pappy Cheshire talking for all the boys and Sally, saying so long, everybody. So long.